There's Dad.
Almost clap.
There's Lacey.
Oh my gosh, she was my mic.
There's Season.
Bonjour.
Hi, Quincy. Hi, Mike. We talked to Quincy on the phone,
too. Yeah, what are those?
I don't know. We'll find out when we get there.
What?
That's a sequel. Here's the airport.
What are you looking for? What things?
Wow, these are nice.
Most of that stuff's yours. Caesar? Yeah, on the back.
Wow, nice furniture.
Yeah, isn't it?
Okay, Caesar, come on. Let me shut the door. It's okay.
Where's the rest of it?
Where's your fish tank at?
There.
Much nicer refrigerator than what we had.
Bedroom.
Oh, you should have both of my picture in here.
Ooh, that's pretty. Okay, let's
see. Never has enough.
I got clothes all, I got shoes all stacked up on each other.
Oh, this is a huge bedroom.
No, go ahead.
I haven't checked my email.
Oh, you don't have anything.
No, I'm talking about my email.
Because
I keep it on the internet.
What's that?
That's a battleship, isn't it?
Yes.
Wait for Dad. Ooh, hello. Come on, sexy.
This is Mexico. There's Dad.
That orange shirt. Can't lose him.
Watch your head.
Come on, Dad. Dad, come on. There's no cars coming. It says walk.
What?
Hey, good morning. Good. How are you?
Good.
All right.
How are you?
Excuse me. Hola.
She'll like that. That's pretty.
That's a $35.
$35?
I want to give you for only... I told you what, I want to give you this and the tall ring for $10. You're paying for your girls, right?
No.
Mitch. Excuse me. Can you put $3 for the one today?
For the one
today. Can you put $3?
There's Dad and Lacey right there.
Okay, this isn't going.
We're waiting for the bus to get back on. And that guy right there is trying to sell us some bracelets and jewelry and whatever.
That are fake.
Yes, and he will not leave us alone. There he is, right there. Beach tomorrow.
Because I still get into the water. Okay, I'm gonna try now.
All those sailboats.
You can tell which one of us is from California.
Man, look at that sailboat.
That's gonna crash.
It looks like about to tip, doesn't it?
Yeah. It's going backwards.
There
they are.
That boat's gonna crash.
He told me he was gonna tell me when we got there.
Okay, Lacey, what's this called again?
La Jolla.
Mount Soledad?
Yeah, just Mount Soledad.
We got a train going on there. Picture that train, see it, Bree? Down here. See it? Zoom in on it.
Cool.
Right. Get a picture. Mr. Move.
I need the temple. Where's the temple?
This is 5.
There's the temple.
You see this, the one going up beside it? That's the 5, and this is 805.
Wow, that's nice.
Boat out there looks so small.
Can you see your binoculars?
Fingernail.
Oh, this is pretty.
Like panoramic. Let's get the pier in there though. That's too bad you don't have like zoom or anything. Because mine does that. That's what I should do is come up here and take a picture on a real pretty day and blow it up real big and then put it in my bedroom or something.
There's a sailboat out there.
There's 2 of them. I stick each of everything. You see the other one?
Yeah, I see it.
I see the salt and pepper.
Dad!
Right there.
Salt and pepper. I don't know.
The people in the water, you say it's calm? What about these?
Trees.
See them.
Sea lions are out there too. There's people on the water.
Hold on, my battery's
come here. Can you?
They're moving fast.
Zoom it all the way in.
I did.
I see a boat out there too. That's where we're headed next downtown.
There's an island or something there.
That's North Island?
No, it's just a little island.
Oh, that is Harbor Island.
Got some kind of a radio tower or something? There's a lot of people in the bay, just like on the jet skis.
Yeah, they go over there on their jet skis because there's no waves.
You
do it again.
Do it again.
Old Taco Bell.
What's tomorrow mean?
Mañana means tomorrow.
Dad, be still.
You had your foot.
Hold on. Those boats.
Panoramic.
Mm-hmm.
You sure. Sailboat spree. All right, that's my film. That's way too small.
It is a small house. It's a lighthouse.
your feet.
Say hi.
Look over here.
Better?
Hey, hi, Arthur.
Your feet tickle? Where are they?
Okay.
Where are they?
Look, there's this.
There's Amber. Hi, Amber. Wave, oh. Amber. Say hi.
You know Grandma?
She's all that's enough.
Talking about you and your itinerary. Yeah, we had to go get some new shoes because this was old. So, yeah, don't.
Say hi.
Hi, how's it going?
Hey, Amelia.
Say hi. Say hi.
Arthur, can you look at the camera? Come here.
Hey, Arthur.
Arthur, look it. Say hi.
Hi.
Say hi.
Get off me.
Hi, Amber.
Family portrait.
And she's a ham.
Karen.
You hold the baby, hold her neck.
And Johnny's over there. Are you a big girl?
Yes.
Yeah.
Big girl?
Yes.
Yeah. It's going this way.
Want to go with Pfizer down there?
Damn you.
Do you guys want a Pfizer?
Lauren.
Where?
Lauren, hold the baby's carrier because I'm going to make her water.
They don't say anything. They'll probably say hi.
They can jump off.
Here comes the dolphin. And if you're tempted to sing along, well, please do. Sometimes even I forget the words. Let's see if we can get the sun to come out. Let's do a song about the sun. Little darling, it's been not long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been you. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right. Little darling, the smile's returning to the faces. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Yeah, sir, it's alright. Sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, 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 here it comes. People work with me on this, okay? Let's... I know it's early. Let's follow a man who's playing the guitar. Let's try that again. Don't look so surprised when the water splashes in your eyes. Much better. We just thought you might like to know about the M&M. There you go. If you like that camera or that dress, don't let the salt water make a mall a mess. Stay giant. Won't you please move higher? Now you know the words. Let's see which section we can get the loudest. You're sitting in the first nine rows. There's something you ought to know. There's a fair buddy, fair footy badge. You'll get 100%. So surprised when the water splashes in your eyes. eyes. We just thought you might like to know about the internet. If you like that camera or that dress, don't let the salt water make them all a mess. Stay dry, won't you please move on? One last chance. Stay dry, won't you please move on? Folks, listen to me. Let's focus for a moment. We do not call those seats the soak zone for nothing. I promise you on that one. And a couple of reminders, while the animals are splashing, and they will splash, if we can have no running or pushing, that'll keep everybody here safe. And if you need to leave the stadium anytime, please exit up the stairways to the top of the stadium. And finally, we kindly ask you to refrain from smoking here at the Dolphin Stadium. But then again, you already knew that now, didn't you? For those of you who just joined us, my name is Michael. I'm the character here at Discovery Cove, so named for the constant sense of wonder. A sense of wonder brought to us by these magnificent... Stars, along with trainers Becky, Michelle, Amy, and Danny.
Well, thank you very much, Michael, and welcome to beautiful Discovery Cove. Once again, my name is Becky, and it's my privilege to introduce you to our family of whale and dolphin stars. And we're going to get started with the most familiar, the Atlantic bottlenose dolphin. Coming up first in the slide out is an animal brand new to training. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Purina. There she is. She's a 7-year-old female, also brand new to training. Please welcome Melanie. Now we'll get ready with the veterans here at Discovery Cove. This is Misty. Now check her out in the sub zone. She's coming to give you guys a wet wave hello. This is Sandy. In the corner of the pool, because here comes Dolly the Dolphin! Go, Dolly, go! Well, folks, we've also been joined today by two Pacific pilot whales. First up is the oldest and the largest, a 41-year-old female at 3,000 pounds. Her name is Bubbles. Wow. And right behind Bubbles is her very best friend in the whole wide world. She's a 17-year-old female and weighs 1,800 pounds. Here comes Shadow! Now, folks, we also have two very special animals that I haven't yet introduced. Right in front of the show, we have our baby Atlantic bottlenose dolphins. We're going to see if they can try a couple of behaviors on their own. Coming out to give you guys a nice smile at the glass. These are our babies, Malibu and Diego. Sandy, you guys get it? Sandy, Diego? Now keep your eye on these two. They're not too sure what they're doing out here, but they sure do have a good time doing it. And Malibu and Diego represent the world's most successful breeding program of Atlantic bottlenose dolphins. But SeaWorld has had success not only with dolphins, but penguins, puffins, sea lions, walruses, sharks, and of course those great big black and whites and killer whales. Well, here they come out of the glass. Ladies and gentlemen, our whale and dolphin stars. We've also been joined today by a family picked right out of the audience, and here's Michael to introduce them to all of you.
Well, thank you very much, Becky. We're the Boris family, all the way from Las Vegas. Hi, what's your name?
All the way.
Tom. Nice to meet you, Tom. Now, in just a few minutes, you have a chance to help us with the behavior right out there in the audience. But right now, let's talk to this little lady. Hi, what's your name? Ashley, I tell you what, let's see if we can get the crowd out there to say hi, Ashley, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Hi, Ashley.
Now, Ashley, you're getting the chance to meet Dolly off like a real trainer does. But right now, if you and Dad can have a seat there, I'll go ahead and talk to Mom here. Hi, Mom. What's your name?
Peggy.
Nice to meet you, Heidi. Have you ever met a pilot whale or a dolphin before?
No.
Now we'll step on down here with me, Heidi. There's somebody wants you to meet, and Danny will introduce you.
How you doing, Heidi? Thanks for being our volunteer. I tell you what, let's go ahead. There you go. Put that backpack on. You're going to be interacting with Shadow right now. In fact, you're going to be her trainer, okay? You'll be asking for all the signals. I'm going to take a step back. She's all yours. She's watching you spin around in a circle. I'm just standing here. Look at that. She's already training a pilot whale, folks. Very nice. Let's roll right into the next signal. Put your right arm up, wave it up and down. And what is she gonna do? Uh-oh. She'll go out there and give everyone a great big wave. Hello. You guys wave back, folks. She can see ya. Very nice. These animals have excellent vision both above and below the surface of the water. There you go, Shadow. I think you got everybody. Now, the next signal is this. You're gonna put your hands out like this. When she pops up, make sure she's looking at you. Shake your hands up and down, okay? Here she comes. Look at those eyes. Shake those hands up and down. Very nice. You're doing an excellent job, Heidi. I tell you what, part of being a trainer, you have to help us reinforce her, and she really loves squid. So put your hands out. Come on, you signed up for this. Look at how slimy it is. They're all laid in there. Very nice. Okay. It's in there. Toss that in. Good job. And don't worry, that smell should go in about 2 weeks. Okay. Hey, and for our last signal, let's do this. Put our right hand on our heart. Drop it down to the water like that. And you know what you're going to get?
Splash.
Not splash, but a big wave goodbye. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get a big round of applause. You did a great job, Heidi. Thank you.
John, Heidi, because you've been such a great volunteer, we'll represent you on behalf of Fujifilm USA, this Fuji Quick Snap camera. I hope you capture some special memories. Here's for any squid you might have on your hands. Let's give Heidi another big round of applause if we can. Right now, the trainers would like to share their very favorite time of the day. And what's that?
Playtime!
Playtime, of course. Okay, gang, go for it.
Everybody. Well, folks, you don't have to be around these animals long to see that they have a lot in common. As you can see, they love to get you wet, and they love to jump. Right now, we're going to get set to perform the animal's favorite behavior, and that behavior is called the hurdle jump. And with the help of our volunteer, Tom. How you doing, Tom? You can work your way to those stairs like Don's instructor. Tom! Boy, that made my day, buddy. You drink a lot of coffee, huh? Okay, Tom, you look like you're safe. Dolly's gonna come back to stage.
Thanks,
you head back up the stairs that you see right behind you until you get to a blue dot. That was cool. Hey, you know what, folks? This behavior is going to demonstrate the natural teamwork ability and coordination of these animals. They're communicating with each other always. We're going to try to get them over the rope at the same time. So, Tom, pull in that rope hand over hand. We're going to get these dolphins ready here at stage. We're going to try to get the rope 6 feet above. That looks good. The dolphins are set. They're on their way. They're going to take a side. Wait a minute. Dolly, you didn't go. You got to go. She'll meet them at the bottom. Ladies and gentlemen, working together are Atlantic dolphins. Hey! Amy, did you see what just happened? What was I just talking about? Teamwork, coordination, working together. Dolly pulled the rope down. You guys are a bunch of cheaters. Yes, you did. What a way to start the day. What's the problem? Mike. What did they say? The rope? The rope's too high. Hey, folks, do you guys believe that? Oh. I didn't think so. Do you want to see just how high a dolphin can really jump? Yeah. All right, let's wake up. Do you want to see just how high a dolphin can really jump? Yeah. There you go, Tom. Grab the end of the rope from Don. Head up the stairs until you get to Carlos. There's a gold star right on the stairs. That's where you're going next. We're going to show you just how high a dolphin can really jump. Working with Dolly over the years, we've noticed that she has an incredible ability to jump. Not the last height you just saw. Hold on tight, Tom. That rope's going a whole lot higher. Looks like he's set. She's on her way. She'll take the sliding jump on the right-hand side. Now diving down to build up speed and momentum. High flying Dolly! Job, Dolly. Hey, Tom, thank you very much for your help, but you know what? You're not done yet. Carefully down and onto those stairs. We've got a special way to thank you for being our volunteer. You're going to get a big, wet SeaWorld dolphin hug. Okay?
He's hugging.
Up on those stairs, Tom. This is all you have to do. Okay, I'm glad you saw Dolly coming. All right? This is all you have to do. You're going to put your arms out like this, nice and wide, and when she pops up, you lean over, squeeze tight, and give her a hug. Okay? Good job. Oh! Oh my
God! Oh! Oh, I'm crying.
Hey, Tom, I got your hat. That's not supposed to happen, though, Tom. What's that? Okay. She's going to go ahead. Becky's going to rinse that off with fresh water. She'll toss it in the dryer. We'll get it back to you at the end of the show. Hopefully it'll be dry. I'm sorry we laughed, Tom. That was funny. I don't know what to say. Hey, let's give him a big round of applause, folks. You're a good sport, Tom. Why don't you head on back and meet your family? How are you, Mikey?
Well, thank you very much, Danny. Hello again, everybody. Now, you remember Ashley. Well, Ashley's here with me, and she's on her way to a close encounter of the very best kind. As you can see, Ashley is outfitted in the very latest of San Diego footwear.
Hey, nice boots, Ashley. Why don't you come down this way? How old are you? 8 years old. Have you ever met a dolphin before? No? Well, today's going to be your lucky day, okay? Because you're going to meet a dolphin just like the SeaWorld trainer. How does that sound? Cool? Okay, what I want you to do is this. Put your hands high over your head, just like that. Now, Ashley, when I count to three, you dive in the water, okay? Dolly's going to come by and she'll pick you up, and then she'll take you for this cool ride that goes all the way around the pool, and all you have to do is just smile and wave at all those people, okay? Okay, is Dolly ready? Okay, Ashley, here we go. One, two, three, jump! I was just kidding. Boy, we're gonna keep you dry, okay, so I can keep my job. But look who's coming. You're gonna meet her anyway. It's Dolly. Go ahead and pet her. Cool, huh? What does she feel like? Like a dolphin. Okay. Hey, are you ticklish? You are? Well, Dolly's ticklish right here. Tickle her like that. I think you found it. Hey, let's give her this fish. There's a smelt. Oh, that's okay, she'll get it. She's got sharp teeth, okay? Okay, there's a smelt. here is a herring, and you know what kind of fish that is? It's a dead fish. Give it to her. Good job. Now smell your hands. They're fishy, huh? Go ahead and wipe it off on that Pokemon shirt. The smell goes away. It's going to be a long ride home, folks. I tell you what, why don't you go up on stage with Becky? I got a great idea. Hey, Dad, why don't you take a picture with Dolly? As soon as she gets up there, there you go. Come on up, Dolly.
Okay, Ashley, look up here. Your dad's taking a picture. Smile and right up here.
Okay, hey, Tom, are you all right? Why am I not surprised, buddy? Obviously, you can swim, right? Are you embarrassed? Yeah. Hey, Tom, don't get scared, but look behind you, okay? You make me laugh, buddy. You scream like a girl, okay? This is what you're gonna do. She's gonna bring you back to stage along with Sabrina. Hey, Tom!
He's underwater, Danny.
Tom! Hold on, can you guys see him over there? Hey, get off the dock! Oh my goodness! Okay, Michael, put out your hand and grab him, buddy.
Jump off the dolphin, Tom.
I gotcha. Buddy! Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Dolly, Misty, and our amazing volunteer, Tom! And as you probably figured out, Tom's actually a SeaWorld trainer. Gotcha! I have no idea we're gonna top that, Becky.
We're gonna leave it up to these magnificent animals! Watch out! Seen anything yet, folks? If you thought that was getting wet, this is getting soaked. Watch out for Shadow! It's too late to move now, folks.
Discovery Cove, this lighthouse helps remind us of our responsibility to lead the way. Now, today, using the Borst family, interact with our dolphin family. Now, this was made possible as a result of over 30 years of learning, building close relationships with the animals, and developing safe training techniques. Remember, it's never a good idea to interact with dolphins or any other animals in the wild because somebody might get hurt. We'd like to thank our very special guests, Ashley, Heidi, and the newest member of their family, Tom. And on behalf of SeaWorld, Fujifilm USA, and the rest of us here at Discovery Cove, thank you. And have a great day at SeaWorld. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your summer night here at SeaWorld.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your safety and...
It's going the same way I said before. Free, because you've only got about that much.
She's not even paying attention to you.
Yeah.
They just hit it again and it stops.
Yeah, that's what I did. But he's doing it again.
Thank you.
All right, thanks a lot. Well, what's up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and aloha!
Aloha!
Aloha! Come on, work with me here, people. From the diaphragm, I said aloha!
Aloha!
Oh yeah, that was much better. Never mind, this ain't the luau anyhow. This is the story of Clyde and Seymour's Island Adventure. Relax and you'll see a show that is starting soon. Our heroes try to change a pace and now they are maroon.
Oh no, we are maroon.
One's a true blue friend of ours, the other's a real wise guy. Who's who, you ask? Don't worry, friends, it's Seymour and Clyde.
Seymour and Clyde.
All right, now my native name is Manis Nakalaranatalia. You can all call me Juan Ho. Now the story you're about to... Sorry about that. Now the story you're about to see here is true. Oh, in fact, it's been changed to avoid a big lawsuit. Now we have a wide variety of critters here on the island. But first, do you know what time it is? Oh yeah, it's showtime, that's right. Places, everybody, places for the top of the show. It's time for Clyde and Seymour, Maroon! Now, as we begin, what's up? Tastes like chicken. Okay. Now at this point in our story, it is early morning and Doc Robinson is asleep in her hut. Now check this out, because any minute, Doc's alarm clock should go off. Shh.
Time to get up.
It's the perfect early morning aerobic workout. You're all set, Seymour? Carry on! Wow, Seymour, that was great! But you know what? You still have to make it all the way back. Like you, then maybe one day we could get off this crummy old island. But every day it's the same old thing. We're stuck out here with no chance of escape and with no hope of any rescue. Oh, Seymour, that's all right, because one day someone's gonna find us. I can see it now. They'll be an intrepid explorer, and they're gonna be having a noble companion just like yourself. And they're gonna be in a jeep falling out of an airplane just like that one right over there. A jeep falling out of an airplane! There goes a parachute! Come on, Seymour, to the far side of the island! We're gonna be rescued at last!
Oh.
1,000 times. Were you listening? Okay, smart guy. If you were, you would have known we're supposed to land the plane first and then take the Jeep. Now look at us. We're stuck out here in the middle of nowhere. Hey, maybe one of these friendly natives could help us out. How about you? Step on down here, young lady. Hi, what's your name? Adriana, that's a very pretty name. Adriana, my pal has a very important question for you. Bless you. I need you to listen up, all right? Okay, Clyde, ask her. Well put. Adriana, we want answers. What my buddy here wants to know is, have you seen the legendary long-lost island of Surlaw? Take that as a big no. Have you seen any island at all nearby? Another big no. How about a big giant volcano that's blowing smoke and spitting fire? You have? Where? Right there? Well, golly, thank you. My pal would like to thank you, too. Reach on out there and shake his flipper. Okay. Hey, would you like a fish? That's a joke. Sit down, kid. Okay, big man, this looks like this is the place. Adriana said so. Come on, let's check it out. Holy smokes. Take a look. Wow. Uh-oh, they've got rats. I don't know about you, Clyde, but I hate rats. Rats or no rats, we're going ashore. I'm sending you first. Okay, buddy, this is it, all right? Hey, wait a second. Somebody took our Jeep. No plane, no Jeep. We're completely marooned. But don't you worry about a thing, we'll make the best of this situation. Come on, let's go. Sea lions first. Hey, looks like somebody lives here. We're gonna have to check this place out from top to bottom. Tell you what, I'll check the beaches and you can check the lagoon. If you're all set, let's see your very best sea lion swim. Okay, Clyde, very nice. Hey, wait a second here. You missed the spot. You better check it out. It's a shark! Yeah! It's a big job, Clyde! Okay, buddy. I'm sorry, I was just teasing about that shark. You understand, though, that's just a little bit of what we call sea lion humor. You know something? We're gonna need to find a way off this island. I suggest we get ourselves the lay of the land. I figure once we have the lay of the land, we can divide the island up into a giant grid. What we'll do is we'll simply check each grid one at a time. If there's nothing there, we'll eliminate it from the list. That rat's making off with my favorite hat. I don't know about you, Clyde, but I, for one, am starting to get a real bad feeling about this place. It's not that scary.
Boy, am I happy to see you. That was so fancy engine with that Jeep and that plane and all that music. When's that plane coming back, huh?
Hey, slow down there, island girl. The plane's not coming back. You're supposed to rescue us.
Oh, no, that's impossible. We were shipwrecked here years ago on a research mission.
That sounds familiar. My buddy Clyde and I are looking for the legendary long-lost island of Surlaw.
So are we. Hey, wait a minute. With this hat and that outfit, aren't you? Sorry.
Oh, you're going to have a long day, lady. Yes, I am. I'm that semi-famous adventurer and explorer extraordinaire, Idaho Jones. This is my good buddy, Clyde.
Well, very nice to meet both of you. I'm Doc Robinson, accompanied by my partner, Seymour, and this place is long lost, et cetera, et cetera. We never found any Surlaw, though, whatever that is.
What's this big ugly thing up over here?
Jones, that's dangerous! Get going away from there, hurry up! Get him away!
Let me go!
guys are gonna have to be more careful. That tiki mask is the gargantuan guardian to the gate of Surla. Legend says when we find the holy golden coin, that bamboo gate will open and Surla will come out here and lead us off the island. Or he'll chase us off, the legend's a little vague. But either way, we can't seem to find that holy golden coin.
Not gonna be a problem, Doc Robinson, because we're gonna find that coin, or my name isn't Indiana Jones!
Hold on. Did you hear what you said? You said your name was Indiana Jones. Read your script, you're Iowa Jones, remember? Idaho Jones.
Oh my. Look at you, it doesn't matter what my name is.
Right.
We're gonna find that coin or I'm not one of the Jones boys. Now all we really need is a plan, and that's not a problem for a guy like me. There's all sorts of stuff swirling around on the inside of my head. Okay, what is it? Right now? Just go in the water.
Come on, Joe. What do you really say?
He wants to know what you did here on the island for fun.
We have lots of fun things to do. In fact, here comes Opie, my athletic director, right now. Okay, thank you very much, Opie. The little guy was really on the ball. Actually, Seymour and I enjoy ripping game of island water polo. So Seymour, when you're all set, right this way and let's show off for our guests. Now you watch this, Jones. You are gonna be thoroughly impressed.
I'm all eyes.
Hi, Seymour. Right over here. There you go. Here's the ball. Now take it away.
Uh-oh.
All right, tell you what. Why don't you throw me that ball? Nice toss. All right, jump. All right, now Seymour's got the ball at the end of his nose. He's gonna take it all the way down the length of this lagoon, build the ball at his feet, and take it all the way up and over the bamboo bar. And now for a fancy sea lion finish. Fantastic! Hey, Clyde, the sea lion, give him a try.
No problemo. My buddy Clyde used to play some college ball. You're about to see how the big boys do it. All right, here's the ball. Head out. Watch closely, you're gonna be fairly impressed. Okay. Okay, you big chicken, this is no time to be acting like that. I need you to be big and strong and brave. Jump. He's got the ball. We're driving down the lake of the lagoon, building up a serious speed to take that ball all the way up and over the bamboo bar. Big pass to Seymour, finish! Fantastic! Hey, you know something? All this activity's gotten us hungry. What's for lunch?
Well, we don't have much of a kitchen on the island, but we do have an excellent microwave. Show them, Opie!
I got this real close. Thank you.
Did you guys get it? Microwave? There's plenty to eat on the island, especially if you don't mind cold dead fish. Seymour and I make a party of it, a regular lunch in Luau. Alrighty, Jones, let's see. Why don't you say we get things started with something to drink? How about some nice warm coconut milk?
Coconut milk? What else do you have?
Lucky for you, he's found a secret supply of diet soda.
I'll go ahead all four.
Okay.
Okay, drink up. Enough. Excellent. Tell you what we're going to do right now, gentlemen. First, I'm going to clean up the beaches for those who might come behind us. We want to make sure we leave it just as nice as when we found it. Then we're gonna get down to some serious grub. Let me see here. I'm wondering what Doc whipped up for us today. Okay, what do you know? Got a hip plate of cold dead fish. All right, here's the gig, gentlemen. I've got a plate of dead fish here. I'm gonna divide it up. Even Steven, I don't want anybody touching anything till they're all divided up. All right. We've got one for Seymour and one for Clyde. That makes two for Seymour and two for... Did not give you a fish? Okay. My mistake, I'll start from the top, no problem. We've got one for Seymour, one for... Aha! I got you that time, you stole that fish, didn't you? Okay, yes you did, I saw you, they saw you, and so did Seymour. Okay. Do you have any idea what happens to a bad sea lion who gets caught stealing fish from me? It's quite simple, actually. But rather than me tell you, I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna have Seymour show you. So if you're all set and you're paying attention, go ahead, show him, Seymour. Not really. We don't really spank him. No, sir, he wouldn't do such a thing. What we really do is sneak up on real quiet, like when they're not paying attention, we reach out to them and we choke them. Not really. We don't really choke them. No, sir, we wouldn't do that. What we really do is touch them very gently, right about here. Either hand. No hands. What was that? That's ridiculous. You boys are too much. All right. Enough horseplay. It's time to get down to the business at hand. And right now, that's finding that holy golden coin. Seymour, you've been excellent out here. I'd like you to search the caves with your kooky buddy Doc. If you can't find anything, come back and check up on us later. Thank you very much. Clyde, you and I, we're going to perform a thorough search. Just so happens, I'm an expert at these types of searches. I want you to stick close to me, buddy. You're going to follow my each and every move. Let's go. That's a little too close, buddy. Ourselves a thing. We're gonna need to come up with another. Hey, wait a second, something's coming this way. We have to hide. You hide there in the lagoon. I'll go ahead. I'll hide under this palm tree. Whatever it is, it sounds huge.
I've got the coin and you'll never find it. Neither, neither,
neither. Huh? That's just little Opie. That tiny little guy, he couldn't hurt a fly. Ow! Wait a second, this is it! The clue we've been waiting for! A latex coconut with a note inside! Everybody, sit back! I'll remove the note! Let's read this note together. It says right here, the legend of Surlaw lies buried at the foot of the great volcano. P.S. You'll never find it. Neener, neener, neener. That does it. Nobody says neener, neener, neener to Idaho Jones. Come on, Clyde. You and I are headed to the foot of the great volcano. Let's go!
Boy, get the little boy.
Oh,
This is funny.
Wow, Seymour, that was great!
You saved it. Wait a minute. He's not breathing. All right, you stay right here, and I'm going to administer CPR. You wish. Seymour! I need your help. You do it. Fantastic, Seymour, and just in time, because you know what I got from Opie? An ancient precious metal monetary unit with a hole in the middle. Hey! You don't suppose this could be that holy golden coin, do ya? Nah. Here, Seymour, you can have it. Put it someplace safe. Maybe the coin deposit? That's it!
Okay. Read it!
You opened
it! Put something in there!
Wait a minute!
It's coming this way!
Look at that big thing.
Come on up here, Sirlaw. You have some explaining to do. Hey, wait a minute. This here is a walrus. That's it. Sirlaw, spelled backwards, is...
walrus.
Walrus, that's right. So tell me, what's up with all this Sirlaw nonsense, huh? Oh, I hate that part.
Hey, what do you say?
Come here, I'll show you.
That's
good. His name is Sir Winston Walrus, and now we found each other, it's party time!
Come on, everybody! Party time!
Okay.
that's the one that's it.
Dad, I'm behind you, be careful. My head just kind of like in front of
me. You have to break the battery going now.
That one's sleeping, Dad.
He's tired.
Dang, that's those look anorexic. Those birds do. Yeah.
So the food that you are feeding the animals is fresh frozen. And this is a way for us to be able to eliminate a lot of the parasites these animals or the fish will have. So basically the food that we sell here is just a snack for them and a way for us to give you the opportunity as our guests to interact with these animals.
He's playing.
Great, but that's just part of the story. The real adventure starts when you sit down. You're surrounded by tropical plants and gadgets and gizmos from all the shipwrecked vessels. And here's the best part, you have animals. Animals that come right up to your table. While you're enjoying a meal, penguins, otters, birds, maybe even a sea lion stop by to visit. So, to check out the hand-carved sandwiches, salmon, ribs, stir-fries, salads, desserts, and special meals just for kids. And then, eat among the shipwreck island. And so, come on by and visit us. Enjoy a great meal, see our animals. Oh, and by the way, we have music. Did I mention we have music?
Did you know that your SeaWorld adventure can continue even after today? Look for us on Shamu TV, in your school classrooms, or on cable. And we make several appearances every year on network television programs for Pete, Penny, and others who are any of your favorite personalities. And you can take the Shamu adventure home with you as well. What you will see here today is the spectacular culmination of everything that we're learning, but it's only a small part of our daily interactions with Shamu. On Shamu.com, find out what's behind the Shamu adventure. Check out Shamu Camp and get to
before we begin, please no running or pushing in the stadium at any time.
Sit tight and enjoy your Shamu adventure.
Glacier Bay, Alaska, the cycle of life begins and ends every day. The glacier that just calved brought tons of nutrients into the water. This abundance of basic food, the entire food chain benefits. It's no wonder this place draws the ocean's top predator, the killer whale. I'm Jack Hanna, and I've been fortunate to have traveled the world. This is one of my favorite spots on Earth. Today, our global journey will take us to several locations, from Shamu Stadium to Alaska, Norway, and the Crescent Islands of the southern Indian Ocean. Shamu will help show us how killer whales have adapted to each of these areas, as well as allow us to share in the beauty and majesty of the top predator of the sea.
Welcome to the world's largest killer whale facility, the home of Shamu and Baby Shamu. Our four SeaWorld Adventure Parks are home to 20 killer whales and the most successful breeding program in the world. Today, we will lead you through the Shamu Adventure, an experience that lets you be part of the discoveries we make every day, not just here at SeaWorld, but all over the globe. The scientists, experts, and researchers continue to explore the world of the killer whale. And over the years, we've discovered a creature that has the ability to acclimate or change its behavior in order to thrive and flourish in various environments. Some of these elaborate behaviors are best exhibited when killer whales are hunting as a team. Jack Hanna takes us to Norway, where we spy on a variety of marine animals, using their tail flukes for slapping, stunning, throwing, and tossing. This weakens, injures, or tires their prey into defensive state, which makes the pursuit that much easier. Shamu doesn't chew his food like we do. His teeth are designed for ripping and tearing. Check this out. As this ability allows killer whales to prey on animals much larger than themselves. And as you can see, with these powerful abilities and their adept teamwork, killer whales will always be the ocean's top predators. At SeaWorld, the connection we developed with Shamu over the years has created other highly skilled teams as well. Every trainer who works here must respect the power, strength, and intelligence of these animals. With that basis of understanding, we're toward building a relationship with each animal. What we present here today is the result of years of one-on-one interactions that's created a special bond between animal
Yeah.
one of the most important parts of a trainer's job is building relationship with the animals. It's not easy, it takes time, and not everybody picks it up right away. Today, we're going to give a couple of you a chance to start building a relationship with the killer whale. Visiting us today from New Mexico, please welcome Jessica and her father, Bill.
That's right, I got Jessica over here. Jessica's waved to everybody. Everybody wave back to Jessica. All right, have you ever met a killer whale before, Jessica? No, this is going to be a whole lot of fun. Now, the first thing you want to do when you're working with a killer whale is develop a nice, positive relationship. Sound like a good idea? All right. So what we'll do is we're going to offer Shamu a back rub and just see how he enjoys that. That's one way we can let them know they're doing a good job or that we want to be their friend. So reach out here with me. Let's give them a back rub. There we go. They have very sensitive skin. He seems to enjoy this. What do you think he feels like? Weird. A lot of people say they feel like rubber. Well, I tell you what, let's see if I'll take some signals from you, okay? That's a good way to see how your relationship's going. So I'm going to ask him to watch you. Now go ahead and spin around in a circle, Jessica. Do a couple spins there. And look at that, you're dancing with a killer whale. Great job. Let's try one more, okay? Why don't you just put your hands out to your side like this. Now wave your hands. And look at that, he's waving right back to you. Fantastic. Okay, well, let's offer some of his favorite treats. Here's a herring. Just throw that right in there. Now you notice that they swallow their food whole, so don't forget to let go. Here's a couple smelt. Great job there, Jessica. Well, it looks like you're off to a fantastic start over here. Let's check in the other side and see how your dad's doing with Wendy and Shamu.
Well, thank you, Ken and Bill. Before we get started, turn around, give everybody a wave hello. You guys make them feel welcome. Were you having Jessica feed Shamu?
Yeah, I sure was.
All right, we're going to try that too. So what we're going to do, Bill, is take this fish, get to know Shamu by simply tossing that in her mouth. And we're going to see what... How is she taking your fish, Bill?
Hey, I got this fish from this guy, Bill. I don't want it. Here you have it.
Did she get it? No, thanks. I don't want it. It's fish.
Oh man, that's not a good sign, Wendy.
I don't know what that was all about. Maybe you should keep it going over there with Jessica.
All right, let's try another signal, all right, Jessica? Go ahead and march in place. Now lift your knees up nice and high so they can see you. And look at that. No knees on this whale. They're going to do a killer whale style. Great job. And we got a natural over here, Wendy. You know what? I'm going to wrap things up over this side by letting you give a great big hug. So they're just going to come in nice and close for you. Come on up here. And reach out there, wrap two arms right around, give him a great big hug. All right, how about a nice hand for Jessica? Great job.
I think that was a nice touch over there. You know what, I'm going to have you give Shamu a signal, Bill, and we'll see how Shamu responds to you. Go ahead and put your hands out in front of you, like so. Toss them up over your head and wave at Shamu. Go ahead and do it. Basics. Just get to know Shamu a little bit. Put your hand out there and just rub her down. Whoa! Oh my goodness! Wait a second, Bill, was that you? You know what? I can only think of one other thing left to do. So what I want you to do, come over here, Shamu. We're going to have you give Shamu a signal. And the signal is to give him a great big kiss. But let's do it from the glass. So come on down here, follow me. You're gonna take your left hand, she's looking right at you. Blow her a big kiss with your left hand. She got the signal, now put your left cheek against the glass like so. Look right over that camera, Bill. Now, the important thing is not to move. Don't take the dry with this umbrella. Here she comes. Looks like you have a feature in animal training, but as for you, Bill, we have this cool SeaWorld beak towel with your name written all over. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, honorary trainer, your dad, Bill.
That looked like fun, didn't it, Julie?
It sure did, Jack.
But we shouldn't forget the fact that Shamu and all killer whales possess amazing abilities that demand respect.
That's true. And in their quest for survival, killer whales are fierce and skilled hunters. Depending on what type of animal they're pursuing, the whales have mastered different methods to catch their prey. In the southern hemisphere off the coast of Patagonia, killer whales haul themselves out onto the beach to feed on numb sea lions. And on the other side of the world, 2,500 miles off the coast of South Africa, lie the Crocet Islands. Here, the whales are observed teaching their young different hunting techniques. One method is to hide among the kelp beds to sneak up on their prey. These thick beds provide an excellent hiding place for the patient killer whales. At the right moment, the unsuspecting penguins are plucked from the kelp. The second method taught to the young whales is to intentionally beach themselves to hunt elephant seals off the shore. Because of the risk of being stranded, the calf's mother often helps him returning to deeper water. After a lot of practice, the end result is a successful catch.
This hunting is additional proof of Shamu's true potential. Hi everybody, my name is Wendy, and I've worked with Shamu for several years. During that time, we've trained, we've played, and sometimes we just hang out together. One of the results is the ability to perform at a high level of skill and cooperation. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, focus your attention to Shamu as she prepares to show off some of her most spectacular behaviors.
Thank you.
gone worldwide in an effort to appreciate and understand more about the killer whale. The great part is that your experience doesn't have to end. Visiting us online at Shamu.com will keep your global journey an ongoing adventure. The website includes your experience here today.
Riders.
Riding the needles, all hydrocross racers on wave running by